grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, after man died with Christ and rose again to new life, may he now share with him eternal glory in heaven forever.
Amen.
Our innocence here.
Martin could spot the ridiculous
that areas, anywhere. He was best loyal to his family and true to the Lord. Martin was one of nine siblings born to Alicia and Ronald Bragg. To say our childhood was upbringing was simple, it is an understatement. We had described as we had chaos in those days, but we surely had togetherness. He attended CIC College and lived with Carol and Teresa in Port of Spain, where I'm sure the ladies kept him in line. Five of us moved on in different directions after the passing of our mother, some to England and some to Canada and some to Port of Spain. The youngest maintained their true roots and stayed loyal to the island. Regardless of the distance, we all found a way to keep in touch and come home to play carnival with Martin and Marie. Martin was a man of many talents and loves. He liked playing rugby with the Caribbean men's club. Watching sports on TV any kind, and was known to have expert opinions on ice hockey. Every year he looked for carnival, steel band, and steel band panorama competitions. And drink carts would be overflowing as he took to the streets. Drink in hand and jumping up during the last lap. He took pride in his garden, loved the fish, and especially looked forward to the return of the visitors to the rock. So that we could go to cookouts together. Cooking was Martin's joy and passion. And I am sure some of you were lucky enough to share a meal with him. But his family was also his love. Martin met his soulmate, Marie, and they got married. They started their family together and have three beautiful kids, Matthew, Maria, and Marcus. Martin's desire to support his family led him to various careers, such as working in the family factory, beginning an upholstery business, a talent he surely got from Dad. And sharing his love for great food with his catering business. Martin was quite a character, larger than life, for a little brother and very playful. One memory I have is when Martin came to Canada in the summer to visit. We went to a cottage in Muskoka for a weekend. Martin attempted to gain the attention of some sunbathing girls and slipped and fell in the dark, breaking his arm. I had to take him to the hospital. Yet it's sad. And since he had no insurance, I let him impersonate me. He pulled it off and said, "No problem, man." You always could find a way to talk his way out of any situation. With his head thrown back and his infectious laugh, he could hold his own. in, no one saw me but the blind man. It was truly a great guy. And the life of his, and the life of the party, mostly when he was playing sailor. He would be missed. Like, he would be missed every day by his wife. The serum is sibilant, and especially his body to the Lord. I would like to thank everybody who has come here, come near and far, to celebrate what is life with us. We have family and friends from Vancouver, Ontario, and the United States here today. The spirit of carnival will never be the same without you, Martin. Please join me in a short prayer. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee.
Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Rest in peace. Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who have set a limit to this present life, so has opened up an entry into eternity, we humbly beseech you that by the grace of your mercy, you may command the name of your servant, Martin Bryan, to be inscribed in the Book of Life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare for all peoples a banquet of rich food. On this mountain, he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. Word of the Lord.
Thank you. and that I should raise it up on the last day.
Your loneliness will be taken away.
And that is what we heard about in the first reading that shows it probably because, as they say, like overlap, that on this mountain God will set a great feast for those who belong to Him. So that choices, wines, and meats, and everything that we need will be there. So it is complete, so we can have that rest deep inside of us. But then, those of us who hear the call of God, and I always say that blessed are those who hear it. We're the ones who become believers and we seek to live out God's will, and we already accept His love in us, and we strive to remain in His love. And that is because we know that all the things that we do here on earth, that nothing will ever bring us a fulfillment that we know we desire and we are seeking. Nothing. Doesn't matter our profession or our status in society. These things kind of make us feel nice, probably make us feel better than others, but they never bring us fulfillment. In the long run, all people are the same, that we are lonely by birth and we seek fulfillment. But those of us who believe and we come to understand the goodness of God, we are people of tremendous faith. And as we live our faith, we begin to find that somehow, even though we don't have fulfillment totally, this faith gives us a foretaste of what it is going to be. So we live it out. It tells us to live in the love of God. In it we find fulfillment. And so we give ourselves to our neighbor. We give ourselves to our family. We give ourselves to our church. And something of that fulfillment starts to dawn on us. And we begin to realize that this loneliness will not be forever. That in God, it will be removed. Here we come to say goodbye to Martin. And he was one of those persons, I believe, who hear the call of God and recognize that yes, in this life, he must enjoy it. Have a lot of fun in cooking, in carnival, in meeting together with his friends and cracking a lot of jokes, but also in good family life, in the love that he gave to his wife and the way he tried to bring up his children. And yes, he was a man of tremendous faith who was dedicated to his faith community and to this parish. And he did a lot for us. So yes, not only you will miss his cooking, but we are going to miss his cooking and harvest. You know. But what I find about him that I liked, and I went to the home on one of the nights of prayers, and I mentioned it there, is that during the Christmas time, we talk about Joseph. You know how he's a faithful father. And somehow he reminds me of Joseph, a faithful husband and faithful father. A man of tremendous faith, a man of prayer. So yes, his zest for life, but a man of prayer, a man of God. And when you meet somebody like that, you know that it is not length of life that comes, but the quality of life. And the quality of life is not in probably our profession, but in the way that we give our hearts unto others. This is what is beautiful. And this is really what makes people people. And in this case, makes a man a man. I like to mention a lot when I speak where I still have men. That we do have a problem in the world with the way men behave. But he was one of those who strive to be a real man. Now, it is his life, his spirituality, his manifestation of the real self, full of joy, but deep respect for others, faith in God, loyalty to family and friends, that speaks with vitality. that he was, as a human being, a tremendous success. It is not what you have to show, but who you are. And I hope that his family, especially his children, that they recognize that, and that we realize that he has left a great legacy. And it would do you very well if you recognize that as the most important thing that he has left for you. And if the other members of our church family would recognize that also. And if the rest of his family come away and his friends would recognize that. Because we're looking for such people in the world. And we're reading some books on Caribbean masculinity. And it's awful the way they understand Caribbean. So that when you meet someone who's trying to be a real man after the heart of Jesus Christ, there is a reason to celebrate. And there's a reason to have hope that all of us can somehow live the way that God wants us to live. But we have to be people of faith. Yes, it is true that in this life, we strive to do this and that and the other, use our times and what we call dwell in life, and that is great. But there's nothing better than having a great relationship with God. And this is what we have. And this is what I believe that he has left to be celebrated. And all of us must ponder and really appreciate and somehow try to inculcate in ourselves and pass on to our sons. So once again, I say to the male of his family, his immediate family, and his extended family, and the church, that those areas of his life that show the real man, what the man is called to be, those things are the legacy that he has left for us to take up and to pass on. And know very well that once a person has lived like that, yes, we are sad that they're gone, but he went to hope. And those of us who believe, we also have hope that he's going to live forever. You know, Paul says in Colossians chapter 3, verses 1 to 3, that our life is hidden with Christ in God. And I think that he has a sense of that. So I hope that he finds it fully in God. We say Jesus came here to share our mortal nature, the fact that we're going to die, so that we will rise and share his immortal nature and live forever. So that is our hope for him. And he lived a life in terms of that. Now, so then we have a reason that even our hearts are sad, we have a reason to have a tinge of joy inside of us. You know, one of the beautiful things that Paul says comes in Romans chapter 8, verses 35 to 38. And he says that who can separate us from the love of God? And the answer was not even death can separate us. Not even death. But death has not separated him. He remains in the love of Christ. And those of us who celebrate Jesus, we celebrate that love all the time. That's why we talk about the saints all the time. Because we will ever walk in Christ until that day when we shall be united around the throne of God. We say goodbye, Martin, and you have lived a wonderful life, and may your weaknesses be forgiven by the God who loved you and whom you love in return. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us please stand for the prayers of the faithful. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead. For Martin, who in baptism was given a pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
For our brother, who gave the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised up on the last day. Lord, hear families and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness. Lord, hear us.
Lord,
for those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, Lord, hear us.
Lord,
for the family and friends of our brother Martin, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who after the death of his friend Lazarus, Lord, hear us.
Lord,
all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, Lord, hear us.
Lord,
God, our shepherd and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Please be seated, and the collection will be taken up as we sing, Be Not Afraid.
my brothers, the life sacrifice of yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Be near, O Lord, O God, we pray to your servant Martin, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of reconciliation, so that should any stain of sin have come to him, or any human fault have affected him, it may, by your loving gift, be forgiven and wiped away through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ Jesus, our Lord and God. For as one alone, he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man, he chose to die, so that in your sight we might all live forever. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim.
Thank you.
mystery of us.
Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Bless our Lord's call to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say a word and my soul shall be. May the body and blood of Christ be to us a healing remedy and keep us safe for eternal life. Amen. Your servant Martin, who has journeyed from this world May this sacrifice be cleansed and free from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
So my dear friends, before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Martin. May our fear express our affection for him, may it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall meet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. On behalf of the Britain's grace and wisdom for the spirit, and this entire church family, we extend to the family and friends and those who are left more sympathies, and hope that we will look to Jesus, the greatest of consolers. Believe in him, so that one day you will have eternal life. This moment, we shall once again sprinkle the coffin with holy water to acknowledge that he was baptized, and that he is associated with Jesus and his resurrection. We shall also incense the prophet that our prayers go on his behalf, that one day he will put on the glorious body, like Christ, in immortality. As we sing in the hands.
Thank you.
We give you thanks for the many blessings which you bestowed upon him in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith. Until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our God forever, and let it be to our God, say Amen.
Amen.
Because God has chosen to call our brother, Martin and Brian, from this life of himself, we commit his body to the earth. For we are thus. And on the dust we shall return, but the Lord Jesus will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our brother to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace him in peace and raise up his body on the last day. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord.
May
he rest in peace.
Amen.
May his soul and the soul of all faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Please stand. For the only person pray for God's blessing. May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and let the church say Amen.
Amen.
God, may God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Martin, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and lead you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May the bodies of angels welcome you.